Hello all, welcome to my tutorial. So in this tutorial we'll focus on the bool data type, boolean data type in Python. So boolean data types in Python are basically the two constant values, or we can say the two constant objects, that is true and false, like this, true or false. Only two values are allowed for boolean data type, that is true and false, and always we have to write like this, T in caps and F in caps. Okay, it's a kind of keywords. These two are the keywords also in Python. Okay, so let's declare one variable or bool type. Suppose I am writing like this. If we check, if we print A, we will get true. If we print type of A, then it means it's showing class bool. So that means variable A belongs to the class bool. So that means A is a variable of data type bool. Okay. Similarly, we can write like this: B equals to false. B equals to false, type of b is bool, class bool. It's saying this variable b belongs to class bool, so b is a boolean data type. Okay, next thing we can see, like suppose I'm writing like this, a equals to true. Okay, it will give an error because this is tree in a small case, it's not a valid boolean value. So it is saying that name true is not defined. Okay, so we cannot define the boolean value like this. Similarly, we can check with false. The same way we got the name error, that is saying name false is not defined. Okay, if suppose and also let's see some of the examples for logical operators. Suppose we have A equals to 5 or 4 and B equals to 3, and if you write like this, B greater than A, so it will give false, right? B is not greater than A, so it will give false. Okay, similarly we can write, if you write A greater than B, then it will show true because A is greater than B. Okay, so let's perform some of the mathematical operations on bool data type. Okay, one more thing. So in boolean data type, when we do mathematical operations, or whenever we use for numeric logical operations, these boolean data types will automatically convert it into numbers or integer. Okay, this true value, true, so true always holds the value 1. Okay, 1. And false will always holds the value 0. This is very important. So whenever we perform any mathematical operations on bool data type, it internally first converts true to 1, false to 0, and then perform the mathematical operations. Let's check that. Suppose I'm writing true plus true. Okay, so 1 plus 1 equals to 2, so we got true. Okay, this is the plus operator we are using, so we are adding two boolean values. So it is converting true to 1 and true to 1, and then it is adding 1 plus 1, 2. Similarly, we can check true plus false. True plus false equals to, should be 1. Okay, then true minus true should be 0, so it's 0 only. We can also perform something like this, 10 plus true. Okay, so it will give 10 plus 1, so that means it's 11. 10.5 plus true, so it will be 11.5, so 11.5. okay, suppose false, I'm writing false minus 10.50. okay, so it will give 0 minus 10.50, so that means minus 10.5. okay, so these are all basic mathematical operations. We can perform multiplication also, 1 into 1, 1 multiplication, true multiplication, true. So 1 into 1 into 1, it should be 1. So if you do true multiply by false, it will give 0. Okay, so we got 0. Similarly, we perform true by true, 1 by 1 equals to 1, 1.0. And if you perform true by false, so 1 divided by 0, it will give an error. 0 division error, division by 0, right? So we are dividing 1 by 0, so it's like a 0 division error. Okay, so these are all basic mathematical operations we can perform on bool data type. The last thing I want to say, that the bool data type is, bool data type is immutable. Okay, so what does it mean? Immutable means not changeable. Suppose I am writing x equal to true. Okay, let's check the id of x. So id is an inbuilt function in Python. Using that will always return the memory location address of that variable. Okay, so if you see this 26932025 6, this is the id, or this is the memory location address where the value x is stored. Okay, so now suppose I want to change the value of x to false, so what will happen? Okay, and if you print x now, it is showing 26932072. So that means now the new address is checking. First, when I declare x true, that time the address was 26932056, and now I want to change its value to false. Now the address is 26932, that is a new address. So we cannot change the value at a memory location. Whenever we're trying to change its value, it always allocating a new memory location. So new memory location. So that means Boolean data type value cannot be changed at a place, or cannot be changed at a memory location. That is why Boolean data type is immutable. Okay. Similarly, float is also a immutable data type. I missed to mention in my previous tutorial that float is also immutable. So let's check the example for float also. Similarly, suppose a equal to 10.5. If you see the id of this, it's showing 2924088. If I trying to change the value to 11.5, okay, and if then I will take the id of a, you see that's a completely a new memory location here, right? So that means new memory location. So that means float value cannot be changed at a place, cannot be changed at a memory location. When we are trying to changing its value, it's always taking a new memory location. So that is why float is also a immutable data type. Okay, that's all for this session. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.